Hey guys, I'm going to show you today, just pretty quickly, how to sort of do a style of bassline that's very popular with a lot of electro house artists these days. It's kind of popular, like if you're looking at a lot of the latest songs that are coming out, and similar to like Dirty Loud, and I mean, even Wolfgang Gartner and all those guys, Deadmau5 does it, sort of in Ghosts and stuff, and a few of his tracks. They sort of, the older bass lines used to just be the same synth, and they would make the loop just using that one bass line type sound. These days, a lot of the guys are sort of using, you know, up to sort of five different sounds to make up their, you know, their loop, to make up their bass line. So I'll just sort of show you a very basic way of trying to do that. I mean, it's kind of like you've got to find, you know, some different sounds. So you got to use a couple of different synths, a couple of sounds that work together, cool ways of sort of going in between the different sounds, and just making something that you can, you know, just that one loop has quite a bit of variation into it. And that's kind of, I hear a lot of the people these days making their songs, and I can hear at least, you know, at least three different sounds to make up their bass line sound. So this is something I've just done pretty quickly. The sounds, this is the top one here, bass. I've only got three, and you get the idea even with three. This one is just, I've just made it in massive. Just a two oscillator, pretty simple there, sound. This one was, I just used Amino. Something a bit different there. And I used, in the third one, just Logic's ES1. Oh, that's right. Again, so they're all pretty similar, but that's kind of a good way of getting them all to work pretty well together. But you will see that, like, I have automate parts with cutoffs and attacks and decays and stuff to sort of get some movement and to get them all working together. So if I just mute these, so you can, I've kind of cut them up here so you can see exactly that, you know, that they're all playing, they all just fit into like a little puzzle. If I just mute the bottom two, so this is just the first bass line sound playing with the basic beat. So that's pretty simple. And then the second one. So obviously now I put the third one there, they sort of all merge together to make a, you know, quite cool sounding, you know, a busier sort of bass line, something that keeps the dancer going. So you can hear in this one here with the Albino, I've actually in there, I've got the attack parameter. I'm putting the attack up, so when it gets towards the end half here, it starts to, you know, starts to shuffle along and not be so stabby as when it comes in here. So it sort of shuffles along a little bit and then goes into this next synth here. And like I say, on this one here, you can hear towards the end here the filters are just working, just to get some, you know, just to get some action in there. Yeah, you can see the filters there. So that's just a way, you know, a lot of the guys, I look on the Beatport charts, and at the top of the charts, they've all got these really cool bass lines that, you know, aren't quite the same as the old days where they just picked the one sound and made the, you know, bass line out of it. They're using at least two, three synths just to create something pretty cool. So if you've got any questions, just fire them through. Otherwise, I hope that has been of some help.